Hi, this is Anna with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about how to build a seal logo in Illustrator. We'll mostly use the shape tools to build this, but we'll also touch on some advanced techniques like having the text flow around the top and the bottom of circles, creating a scalloped edge, and also building an appearance. So let's get started. Okay, so first we are going to create a new document. Okay, so I took a picture with my phone of a little sketch that I drew. And we'll go grab that now and bring it into Illustrator. I'm going to resize this to make it just a little bit smaller and workable. And then I'll create a new layer and lock the layer with a JPEG on it. Okay, so now let's get into actually drawing this thing. First, we're going to draw these little shapes in here. So I'm going to get my L tool, which is a circle tool, and just draw out these little beans. And I'm going to copy and paste in front. And we'll just rotate this around and then move it over with my V tool. Okay, so we've got our two little beans. That was really fast. I'm going to go ahead and hide those, so Command 3. And now we'll make these little bitty squiggles. And I'll do this with the pencil tool. So I'll hit N, and then we can just draw some squiggles there. And I'll draw this over here. Okay, now I'm going to unhide, Option Command 3. And now we have our little coffee beans. I'm going to slightly redraw this. So I'm going to smooth out this corner right here by tracing over that path with the pencil tool. Maybe I'll draw it like this. Okay, I think those work. So now I'm going to highlight these two and group those, Command G, and then hide, Command 3. And I'll select both of these and group those, Command G, and hide those. Okay, so the beans are there. We just can't see them because they're hidden. So now let's get our L tool, which is a circle tool. And I'm going to shift and option drag from the center. And we're going to give this a white fill and a black outline. So to do that, I'm just going to hit D. All right, now I'm going to pull up my appearance palette because I want to add some appearances to this. And we'll move this up so we get a little more space to work in our appearance palette. Now I'm going to give this a fill, let's get our color up, of a kind of rusty red. Okay, but I actually just gave it a stroke because that one's in front. So I'll hit Shift X to switch those. And now I'm going to make the stroke just a little bit darker. So if we go into our swatches, I'm going to click the new color group and add both swatches, which is just the brown and the white. So I'm going to choose this swatch and create a new swatch. I'm going to change the RGB and then hold Option and Command and make a dark tonal of it. And that works. I'm going to increase the stroke a little bit there. Yeah. The appearance palette allows you to add several strokes all to one pass. So that's what we're going to do now. I'm going to hold Option and drag the stroke below the fill. So we have one back behind here, but you just can't see it. And so I'm going to change the color to the lighter and then increase that stroke. And maybe we'll make it 75. Now I'm going to copy this stroke and put it behind again. And we'll make this stroke white. I'm going to make it the same width as this circle. So that one is 4. So all I have to do is take 75 and add 4 to it. So 79. But see, half of this goes behind. All that we're seeing here is 2 points. So we have to add another 4 to get another 2 points out here. So we'll make it 82. And now it's the same size. And now let's go ahead and take this stroke and copy it. We'll push that below the bottom stroke. And then we'll make this one about, let's try 100. And now I'll show you how to make a scallop around the edge. All right, so we built our stroke around the outside. Now I'm going to copy this and paste behind. If we do Command Y now, you can only see that small circle. So everything's just applied to that one circle. Now I'm going to expand this by hitting Shift Command E and then expand. Object, expand, and expand appearance. You can do both of those back and forth until you get all the way expanded out to this. And now I'm going to Pathfinder unite this. If we do Command Y now, you can see that we have the inner circle. It has all the effects applied to it and the appearance, and the outer circle, which only has a fill right now. And the reason we don't want to apply the appearance, it doesn't quite work the same way when you go to distort that path. So I need a new circle for my distortion. And now I'm going to hit Shift X to get a stroke on that part, and I'll increase that stroke. And now we'll go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and Zigzag. Now let's see what it's going to do. Let's increase the ridges per segment to 5. And I hit return. So if I want to go back in and edit this now, I can just go to my appearance in my path and choose zigzag. And now I can hit smooth and make sure preview is on. Let's reduce the size a little bit. And we'll increase the ridges per segment again. Okay, that looks about good. So we'll say okay. And now I want the fill to also be this same color. So I'm going to take my stroke and just pull it over into the fill. And then we'll send everything to the back. And now I'm going to resize this, make it just a little bit bigger by holding Shift, Option, and dragging out a little bit. All right, so we have almost everything done. I'll bring this back to the front, and then we can see that we have a little bit of space in here. So I'm going to increase the size of the stroke to get rid of that little bit of space between the stroke and the fill. And now I'll hit Command 0 to view everything. And I'll zoom in, and then I'll send all of this to the back. Okay, so now we have our scalloped edge and everything that we need, pretty much. I'm gonna select both of these and send them to the back because our beans need to be on top of that. So that's Shift Command left bracket. And now let's unhide. Option Command 3 or Control Alt 3 on a PC. Now I think I want to change this white color. I want to switch these two colors maybe, or make this a dark red. So I'm going to click on my appearance again, and I can easily see where that is. So I'm going to hit white for that. And then this outer stroke, I want it to be the darker red. The appearance lets you change it really easily, and you only have one object there. So that is pretty cool. Okay, and now I'm going to color my coffee beans. I think we'll throw a new color in the mix. We'll make these kind of a lighter brown. For the stroke, I'll just use the dark red. I'll click on these with my group selection tool. And I have a keyboard shortcut set for that, which is G. You can set that up in Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts, right there. And then you can just click the letter G if you want G for your group selection. I'll change the black to the darker red. And I'll select both of these. I think I'm going to increase that stroke at least somewhat. And we'll also round the cap of this. That way we get a rounded little edge inside there. Now I'm going to select all, Command A, zoom out a little bit with Command minus, and move this over so I can see what kind of text we need in there. First, I'm going to type Established 2018, and we'll use Oswald font for that. I'm going to just do point type where you click and put the text in. I only really use area type if there's more than 2 lines of text and you have to keep hitting return. That's not a good thing. We'll align these both to the bottom, and I'll change my font to Oswald. Put them both right up here around the middle. Maybe increase the size a bit, or not. I think the 2018 looks a little bit big, so we'll decrease. And then slide this over holding Shift. All right, now I've got them both selected, and I'll hit Shift Command comma to make them a little smaller. And I'm gonna hit Shift Command C to center them. That way they'll resize from the center and that won't be a problem. I'm gonna zoom in and then hit M to draw little rectangles above and below. We'll move that one down with our arrow keys. And I'll use I for the eyedropper tool to choose this outer red color. But it is going to grab both the fill and the stroke. So I'm going to undo that, Command Z. And I'm going to shift click the red. That way it'll only get whatever color is in front here. Okay, so let's move this, center it up a little bit. I'll just option drag these over to the 2018. And we'll hit the I for eyedropper to recolor the 2018. We have one last thing to do, and that's to add the So Tasty Coffee text. I'm going to hit G to get my group selection tool. And I'll copy this, and then I'll paste in front. And this has copied everything in my entire appearance, which I don't want. I only want the circle. So I'll go over to the flyout and clear appearance. And I'm going to make this just a little bit bigger. right here, holding Shift and Option so I resize from the center. And now I'll grab my text tool and get down on Type on a Path tool, and we'll click once and make sure you're right on that circle. And it'll probably put some lorem ipsum in there if you have CC, which I do love that. I'm used to it now, so I really like it. And we'll type in "so tasty." And you'll notice it might be upside down or something like that. When you click on your selection tool, you'll see these little lines. Those will help you position your text on the circle. I'm gonna get right on there and I'll pull. Either way it goes, you should be able to see it at some point. I'm gonna go ahead and go this way, and then we'll take this other one and pull it around so that the bottom sticks are about equal, these right here. With my eyedropper tool, we'll click the Establish to get the same fill color. Now I've already centered this with Shift Command C, but now I'm gonna increase the size with Shift Command Period, or on a PC, it'll be Shift Control Period. All right, now I wanna center this in the space. So to do that, I'm going to get my character palette, Command T, and we'll come right down here to this one on the bottom. That is the baseline shift. With your arrow keys, you can kind of increase that to be right about there. But now it seems a little too spread out, so I'm going to highlight this and then Option left arrow to bring it a little closer together. And a lot of times with text like this, I will manually go between each letter and space in and out by hitting Option right and left arrows. All right, there's a lot of space and a lot here. Okay, at the end of the day, we want the bottom to line up, so I'm gonna hit Command R to get my rulers. And then I'll pull down a guide. And we're pretty close. We got the S lining up with the Y. Looks good. To get the other line of text down here, I'm going to just copy this one and paste in front, which is Command F. And now I can just click on this middle line and bring it right in here like this. Now this is a little tricky to get right. So now I'll reposition this with these. I'm going to type in coffee, Command A to highlight all, and then we'll come down here to baseline shift and we'll put a negative number. And I'll highlight this and then just keep going until it looks pretty centered vertically in the space. I'm going to hit return, and as you can see, we've got a lot of space in there now, so I'm going to Option left arrow to get a lot of that space out. And I'll get right between the O and F and then hit Option left arrow. And between the C and the O, Option left arrow. And now I'll grab a guide and put it right here. It looks like the E is way higher. So I'm comparing this part of the C and this part of the E. So I'm gonna take this and just pull it over. And now they line up along the top. So we are pretty much done, but the colors are a little weird. So let's highlight everything. And we'll come in here to the Recolour Artwork section. And I'm gonna go straight in here to edit. Okay, first I'll edit the red, and I think we'll change the reddish tone to more of a much darker color. So I'm gonna get it kind of an orangey, and then we'll get really dark down here. Wow, that really helped it a lot. Next, we'll take that kind of lightish orange, and we'll make that maybe around the same area. Ooh, I like that one a lot. And then finally, the coffee bean color. And we'll knock that down quite a lot to have it stand off a little bit. It looks like we'll have to manually change that white. So I'll double click here. I think I want it to be kind of a tannish yellow. Oh, that's perfect. Okay, so now I'm gonna center my beans up a little bit. And I think we're done. So now you can see the before and after my little sketch turned into a nice little retro seal. And it looks so clean comparatively. Thank you, Illustrator. But anyway, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I will see everyone next Thursday for another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.